Hi, welcome to Switch2sports. I have a woman sprinter with me. Hi, Poovamma.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
Okay, so neenga vandu a sprinter and 400 meter relay le your specialist. Yeah.
Like I had started my sports career when I was at 7th standard.
Okay.
So it was like just like there was a lot of competition. So I used to take part in football, kabaddi, so all games.
Okay.
So next comes was athletics. I used to do 100, 200 and long jump.
Okay.
I didn't focus on 400 meter at the start of my athletic career.
Okay.
So when I had participated nationals in under 14, it was 100, 200 and long jump.
Okay.
So after that, I just ran a 400 meter race. So like it was a competition there. So my coach told me to just take part. So it was quite good, like without any.
So phone, just randomly you participated?
Yeah, randomly I participated. Then I started focusing on 400 meter.
Okay.
So under 16 junior nationals, I created a national record.
Okay.
So after that, my career in 400 meter started.
Great. So before this Asian Games and all, how were you used to prepare yourself?
Like in juniors, like we, I had my first international in the year 2005.
Okay.
So it was like taking part in the international meet was a great achievement at that time.
Okay.
So it was like a dream come true. Like I represented internationals in junior level. So junior Asian, I won a bronze medal in 400 to 400 meter relay, junior Asian championship.
Mm-hmm.
So after that was the Olympic trial 2008. I was just 18 years old that time.
Okay.
So we had a trial there. So I was 1 in 6. Like the relay team is selected in the base of the first 6 performance in the final finals.
Mm-hmm.
So I was in within the 6th position. So I was selected for the Olympics. So taking part in the Olympics was the biggest dream. Any athlete being an Olympian is a great achievement.
Yeah,
so but once I reached there, seeing the major, like all the world class athletes, even I wanted to win a, no, I can't, I will not say like I want to win a medal in Olympics, but somewhere the international senior level medal, maybe in Asian Games or Commonwealth Games.
Mm-hmm.
So after 2008 Olympics, it was next the 2010 Commonwealth Games. So I was young that time. So all the seniors were in the top place. So I couldn't be the part of Commonwealth Games.
Okay.
So I was quite disappointed and I took it as a challenge. I should come back and like be in the team.
So that was a kind of inspiration.
Inspiration, yeah. But in the year 2011, I had a airline fracture in my toe.
Okay.
So it was very difficult for me. Like whenever we perform well, everyone start praising, and when we don't perform, they don't see the reason why we are not able to perform.
Yeah, yes,
that is the main thing.
It
only
happens in all the sports.
All
right?
The sport,
when
yeah.
you win medal for the country, they praise.
Yeah, maybe
you.
The media or the press people, whoever it is, they just keep telling all those things. And one of the newspaper, like the Karnataka newspaper, they started saying like Poovamma is disappeared. I didn't mind because my family supported me a lot.
Okay.
We used to stay in a place where there was no stadium or anything. So my dad shifted to Mangalore only for me.
Mm-hmm.
And he started traveling up and down every, even now he is doing the same thing.
Okay.
So because of that, and my brother, even he's an athlete. But he got a knee injury, so because of that he couldn't go further. He has more interest than me, but he supports me a lot. And my mom never missed a single national meet.
Okay.
Every meet, I can say like she's my lucky charm.
Oh.
Whenever she's there, I can perform well. Some kind of motivation, inspiration.
Great.
And even my brother, daddy, whenever they get time, they come to watch my event.
Okay.
So 2011, I couldn't do well, and it was like 2009. So 2011, when I started training, I ran my personal best 53.9. I was training under Ramesh sir, the national camp. So it was my first senior medal in 2011. And after that, like when we start winning medal, it will be like an like we
like
should
a
keep
tonic,
yeah, you know? Like it should be, we should maintain the same thing, otherwise we can't move further. So 2012 was the London Olympic qualification. So when I was doing well, from 53 I reached to 52. 52.8 or 53.6 was the qualification mark. So when was the, when there was a last trial for the Olympics, I had a disc bulge back. So I was totally like, that year was my worst year. I can say that worst year. And you know, as I said, there was no one to look after. Even I couldn't say to my parents because I know they will be worried. But I had to say them, and they were so tense. Like I was in the national camp at Patiala. I was not able to move from the bed. It was so difficult. Like I used to cry every day.
Okay.
And I thought I will stop because of the my back. I thought I will stop sports. It will be very difficult for me to move further.
Continue.
Yeah. Like then my brother, my mother, they started telling me, like my brother motivated me a lot. He used to say me, no Poovamma, you can do. You have to show them like you can do. You have to achieve something. So all those things, and there was a physio, Harishankar Verma, he's from Chennai only.
Okay.
So, and they all helped me a lot. He was the physio for the boxing team.
Oh,
so I used to take help from them. He knew, like he knew me.
Okay.
So I went to the treatment by myself, and everything went on well, and I was recovered.
And so much of pain, so much of struggles, but at end of the day, you won Arjuna Award, which is like, it's a prestigious
yeah, like
thing.
Like after 2012, my life started changing. 2013, we had an Asian Championship. I won 400 silver there and 400 women relay gold.
Okay.
It was my first, like after the injury, I came back. And 2014 was the Asian Games.
Okay.
Started making, doing my personal best time. I got qualified for the Commonwealth Games, but we didn't win a medal, but I was I participated there. And Asian Games, I won individual 400 meter bronze and 4x400 relay gold.
Okay. So the
then,
list goes
yeah,
on.
Goes on. 2015 Asian Championship, silver, gold. 2017 Asian Championship, mixed relay, silver, and women relay, silver. So
okay.
from 2013 to 2019, I had never had a break.
Okay.
It was the countries, and I started achieving. And 2015, I won Arjuna Award.
Yes.
So
how was that moment? Because it's a prestigious moment.
Yeah,
right?
I couldn't receive the Arjuna Award because I was in the World Championship at Moscow.
Okay.
So, like everyone started saying, it's okay, you will get some other award, go and receive in the Rashtrapati Bhavan. And after like coming back from World Championship, I received from Sarbanand Sonowal, Sports Minister. So it was a great, like getting an Arjun Award is something really...
Yeah, for every sports personality, it's a dream.
Dream,
right?
Yeah.
Started running and all that. So chinna vayasulende from 7th standard itself, I think you're interested in sports, right?
Like in during the school days, we used to have all the competitions, right? Taluk level, district level. So I used to participate in all the competitions. So a physical director, he told I can do good in athletics.
Maybe is it because of your height or something?
Maybe
or?
Because I can't, like I clicked in athletics, so it was like we reached kabaddi and football at the state level also.
Okay.
So after games it comes athletics.
Okay.
So I was doing good at the very first, so then I shifted to Mangalore.
Okay.
I started training under Dinesh Kunda. So he's the one who recognized me, like I can do 400 well.
Okay.
So after that, I came to the national camp, Ramesh, who is the coach of Duti Chan.
Okay.
So I trained under him for 4 or 5 years, and we had a Russian coach also. So now at present, we are training under Galina coach.
Okay. So for every sports player, I think the coach is very important. So tell us about your coach from the beginning. Who all trained you, and who is your biggest role model?
Like I never seen anyone as a role model. For me, myself, I am a role model because
great.
I came into this field to do because of my hard work and dedication.
Okay.
So coach like physical director Vasant Hegde, he was the one who brought me into athletics.
Okay. He spotted that fire in you.
Yeah, athletics.
Okay.
So after that, when I shifted to Mangalore, Dinesh Kunda, he recognized the event 400 meter for me.
Okay.
So after that, I was selected for the national camp. Okay. And the national camp, the coaches keep on changing. So I trained under Kunju Mohammed sir, Ramesh sir, and there was a Russian coach, Yuri Agranik. Okay. For 2-3 years, I continuously train under them. And at present, from 2017, I'm training under Galina Bukrina.
Tell us about women in sports, because romba varshathukku munadi we know PT Usha ma'am, Anju Bobby George ma'am, and ippo current generation la vandu Poovamma. So in the madri very very few players we keep in mind, right?
Yeah, in those
when
days,
compared to men, the proportion of women athletes are very less.
Yeah, like no, actually in athletics when we compare to the men and women like competitions, men will be having really a tough fight, like okay. It's tough. Like for the Asian Games or Commonwealth Games, we can say like a women, like 400 to 400 women relay is always from past 5 years, we are winning the gold.
Okay.
Past 5 years since, Asian Games is once in 4 years.
Okay.
So continuously we are winning the gold. But boys, we can't say because they will be having a tough fight. So maybe that is the reason like women name you're getting to be heard more.
Yeah.
And those days, PT Usha and Anju Bobby George, when compared to them, they were the only two. There are so many athletes, Ashwini Nachappa, Vandana Rao. Maybe they didn't do further.
Okay.
So these are the one, the main who have won World Championship bronze, and PT Usha ma'am, she's the fourth in the Olympics.
Okay.
In those days, the facilities what we are having now, they didn't have all such things, sponsors or supplements or advanced technology. Now we have like more forward than those time when they used to do sports. But and
okay.
In that time, if they are winning the, like being in the position of fourth in the Olympics, mm-hmm. It's a really great achievement. And now even the competition is higher.
Okay.
Like in those days, it was not that much. But now when comparably, it is really a tough fight. Getting qualified for the Olympics and being in the final is really a great achievement.
Okay, great. And so many people, they criticize with the age. Right, they say women after a certain age cannot excel in sports. So what is your view on that?
See, it depends upon the thinking what they see. Now I am 29 years old. Like age is just a number.
No.
It like I am into this field for 13 to 14 years. I know many of my companions who were there with me for many years, they used to ask me, when Poovamma you're going to get married, still you're into this field. So no, like when they start asking me, it's not kind of demotivation for me, it's an encouragement for me, like
okay.
I have to do something. Like now because of my, I had a tendon injury last year.
Yeah.
So I couldn't do much better. So not many people, but some I know who they started saying like I may not be able to do.
Okay.
so
we saw some articles about you saying that you know, you cannot come
yeah,
back.
Yeah, I think
you're already
I think old. Indians, they have that such thinking. Like
okay.
age is a matter. Like you can see Mary Kom,
yeah.
Who is still
true.
Doing. I know athletics is not, we can't compare to any other field like boxing or anything. Athletics is really difficult, and especially the 400 event. Mm-hmm. There are so many athletes coming up. We can't
okay.
compare the age or the performance.
Okay.
It's just a for me, it's just a challenge. And I want to prove that it should be an inspiration to the youngsters. Even they can do well further. And they should not bother about the age or anything. If
okay.
you're willing to do, or if you're performing well, go for it. Maybe
okay.
30, 35, 40, it doesn't
so
matter.
So age is just a number.
Age is just a number.
Like most of them, we get some mentality, like we ourselves go into a zone thinking that, okay, I'm 30
yeah,
years old,
it
I'm
depends
done.
Because some of the parents, they want their
kids
daughter
to get,
yeah, get married soon.
Yeah.
But in my case, it's nothing that I know they are worried,
okay.
but
okay.
But I am interested into sports and they are supporting me also.
Okay.
And they know me that I will get married.
Okay.
But I have told them to, if I am getting married, I will continue sports. Still, I am like, I can do well, like I can do further. I can maintain this physique and if not, okay, I will drop sports, no problem. But
okay.
Till I can, I will do.
Okay, so one personal question, how do you maintain this body? Please tell me, no. Please, many girls, they want actually, they want to know,
you know,
secret behind the fitness.
Once we like get into the field and have an aim, like, you know, even I feel to eat ice cream, pizza, burger, During my junior time, I was first in the camp in the junior Asian championship in Delhi.
Okay.
So when I saw the food, everything, I started eating everything and I had put on weight.
Okay.
So after that, I came to know like, no, you should have a diet plan, like what we should like to achieve something, not in this national or state level. To be into the Olympics or to be into the nationals, we need to maintain a strict diet and follow, if you follow the same diet.
Okay.
You know, I'm following the same diet.
So you still eat healthy only?
Yeah, we eat healthy. Like one other day we may go for a cheat meal.
Okay.
So that doesn't bother.
Okay.
But once we go be in that diet, so we won't feel to have it. And
okay.
If you have an aim, like we have to perform well in Olympics or Asian Games or Commonwealth Games, so
okay.
automatically the mind will get set to into it.
Everybody is waiting for Olympics 2020. So how is your preparation for that?
This will be my third Olympics.
Okay.
So I can say that triple Olympics. Hat-trick Olympics. So the preparation is going on really well. We have the team is working very hard, and a mixed relay is already qualified.
Okay.
So the women and men relay is yet to get qualified, because individual, even if we get qualified, it's very difficult. Like to win a medal, to win a medal, it's really
difficult.
Yeah, maybe we may or we may not.
Okay.
But our team can be into the finals, that's for sure. Even coach is having the same hope, like we can do really well.
Okay.
Men, women and mixed relay. The preparation is, at present, the preparation is going on really well.
Okay. I just want to ask this. Physical fitness, all that is fine. You work out, you work hard for that, everything is fine. But how will be your mental state when you go for Olympics? Like how confident you'll be, or you'll have a fear? What will be your coach's advice?
No, actually, like when we reached to the stage of Olympics, before that we used to take part in many competitions.
Okay.
So automatically the mentally fear will be... our focus will be just we have to perform well, and relay is a team.
Okay.
So the spirit when we run for the team, it is totally different what we run for the individual. Maybe
okay.
in the individual we may be more pressurized.
Okay.
But when we run for the team, it's really like we are running for the team.
Okay.
We have to give our best. Like if one athlete don't run their best, then the whole team will be blamed.
Okay.
So it is something different. We can say that we are running for the team. And
okay, so you will be more responsible.
Responsible, yeah.
Okay. So what will be Poovamma's advice for the future generation, for girls who want to take up sports as a career?
No, actually, before saying to suggest them, I would like to tell all the parents who are looking for, some say they want to be like PV Sindhu, they want to be like Saina Nehwal or Mary Kom, or all the great athletes. So before that, they have to get they need to stop thinking like education will bother their when they
sports,
sports, like extracurricular activities, not only athletics, maybe any other games or any extracurricular activities. No, it will make them mentally and physically fit. Nowadays, because of this mobile, everyone started playing with the mobile, all those games and all. So, when we come into this field, their mind will be totally changed. No, even we use phone, but when we be in the track, or we don't get time for all such things. Take rest, be on the track, come back, again take rest. The schedule will be the same. So
okay.
there will be no changes.
Mm.
So even we feel sometimes like from so many years we are doing the same thing. We need to get some, we should be freshen up. So no, it depends upon their thinking, especially the parents thinking they have to change. Like most of the parents, they think because of taking part in, being into the extracurricular activities, they can't focus on the studies.
Mm.
So it's totally different. Even we have completed our graduation. No,
And you work also?
Yeah, I work for ONGC.
Okay.
And I got this job because so I am into the sports. No, there are so many engineers, so many doctors, they are struggling to get a job.
Yeah,
no, if we are into the sports field, there are so many options. ONGC, Indian Oil, Army, Navy, Railways. Like when we used to do sports, there are no such options. And now even the Khelo India has been started and they started supporting. And when we used to do sports, there was no such financial support. Yeah. When we reached Asian Games, so we started getting
I was actually about to ask how do you get your financials?
Yeah, when we used to do sports, we didn't have any such
sponsorship.
And when we when I started winning medal in Asian Games, Go Sports Foundation they started sponsoring me, and till now they are doing that. And Nike, they have started sponsoring me from Bangalore. Yeah, so like when we started performing, they started sponsoring us.
So before, that one we have to like highlight,
because you know from the young generation, if they start supporting, they can really achieve greater heights.
Okay.
So once they need support, we can't afford everything. I know my parents have supported me a lot. We can't afford everything on them. Even they have a lot of responsibilities, our studies, everything.
Okay.
So they have to look after it. So now even the Khelo India has been come up. So it is very good support for them. Okay. For the younger generations, they can really do well. And it's really good support what the sports minister is looking up to.
Okay. Great. It was lovely talking to you.
Yeah.
And finally, to end up with, Switch2sports is a newly started YouTube channel. Focus on sports players and their lifestyle and things like that. So, wishes for our channel, please.
It's good what you are looking into, and it's it will be a good support. Especially, I am into the athletics. So, I will be very thankful to Switch2sports, what they are, it will be really a good support for them. Especially like athletics, they are not into the picture like many other games like cricket, badminton, they are really getting more support. So even athletics should be supported really well for the younger generations, and really even they can do really well. And I would like to wish Switch2sports best of luck and success. Thank you. Subscribe to Switch2sports, like, share, comment. Do not forget to bell the button.